Listen to my podcast, play my podcast, check out the link, link in bio. I want you to hear what I'm putting out in the world. Okay, so this is something that I see time and time again. And ultimately, what people are really wanting to do is people are not just wanting to grow listenership, but people are wanting to grow their podcast community. So in this episode, I'm going to dive in. I'm going to tell you six different ways. Well, five, how you can grow your podcast community. Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. What's going on, family? Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. If this is your first time tuning in, the premise of this show is we cover podcasting news as well as podcast how-tos, showing you how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. All right, so let's go ahead and just dive in. Today, we don't have any podcast news, but I wanted to, just for a second, talk about this thing that's called community, okay? And I want to talk about community because this is something that has been a buzzword over the past few years, and this is something that more people are looking to do because by having a community, one of the byproducts would be you grow your listenership. By having community, now you have a warm audience ready to purchase your product. By having a community, this positions you as the thought leader of that group. So let's look at the definition. The definition of community is a group of people living in the same place or having a particular characteristic in common, right? Or it's a feeling of fellowship with others as a result of sharing common attitudes, interests, and goals. The sense of community that organized religion can provide, in quotes. So why do I want to talk about community? I want to talk about community just piggybacking off of the episode that we released last week, where I was talking about people wanting to grow their listenership. And I talked about six ways that you can grow your podcast listenership. So now I want to talk about community. Let's get to it. And I'm not talking about the show that involved Donald Glover and a few other people. We're not talking about that. But in order to truly be successful in growing your community, you have to have a podcast niche, which I have another episode that I released. I'll make sure to link that in the show notes. But you have to get niched down within your niche. John, what are you saying? So let's say your niche is focusing on showing fishermen what's the best bait to use to catch fish in the ocean, right? That's a niche. But then let's go one layer deeper. And then let's say you want to show fishermen the best bait to catch sea bass in the sea, right? So we have a niche, but we're really, 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 really focused in on that niche. That's two layers deep. So in order to create podcast community successfully, the first thing you need to do is you need to get niched down within your niche. And then after you get niched down within your niche, there are people out there and there are people that listen to a plethora of podcasts, right? And just because somebody listens to a podcast doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to leave you a rate and review, doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to buy a product from you, doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to share it with a friend. But when you begin to get listeners who are coming back time after time after time, these are going to be your foundational listeners, right? These are going to be your core listeners. And if you focus on wanting to just grow your listeners even deeper, I did a video on that. I'll drop that in the show notes as well. But you want to encourage your listeners to engage. John, what do you mean, encourage my listeners to engage? You want to put out a call to action. And then through the call to action, you will be able to measure who heard this episode. For instance, one call to action that I often put out, I say, if you're a speaker, coach, or consultant, you want to register for my upcoming training at getpaidwithpodcasting.com. And I put the link in the show notes. So the call to action that I'm putting out for the listener is that if you're a speaker, you're a coach, or you're a consultant, click that link so you can get access to that free training. So that's one way of encouraging a listener. Another way would be asking them to leave a rate on Spotify. Say, hey, if you've enjoyed this podcast and if you happen to listen to podcasts on Spotify, after you hear this episode, I would appreciate it if you would give me 5 stars on this episode if you felt that you got value. Why do we want to encourage listeners to engage? Because when you get them to take an action, now they have more skin in the game. When you get people to take an action, or if you make somebody take out their wallet and purchase a product, you've got them to take an action to which brings them closer to being a part of the community. You bring them into the fold, as they say in the old church. Welcome to the fold. You want to bring people into the fold by getting them, by first identifying them in the niche and then getting them to engage. Because when they engage, then you get to see who they are by face, by name. And then you can even go deeper by sending them a DM, thanking them for listening to the episode, thanking them for sharing the podcast content. Because if they engage first, then you can come back and engage as well. And then now you put a face with the name of that podcast listener, all right? And then when you get them to engage, this is the natural next step. Then you ask, what do they want to hear? Hey, Ron, I saw you, commented under this post that I posted on my Instagram about deep sea fishing. What do you want me to cover next? Do you want me to cover the type of poles that I use? Do you want me to cover my checklist before I go out and go fishing? Like, what do you want me to, do you want to hear my morning routine? Do you want to hear what my songs are that I like to listen to when I'm deep sea fishing? What do you want to hear next that would benefit you? Now you've taken it a little bit deeper and you've brought them a little bit further, because now you're letting them know that they're not just a listener. They're not just a number. Especially when you address them by name, when you reach out, you're letting them know that they're valuable and you appreciate them, right? So you want to ask them, what do they want? What do you want to hear? Like on the notebook, my man was saying, what do you want? What do you want? What do you want? So you want to get clear with the audience about what they want and what that listener wants to hear that will benefit them. And then you begin to put them together. You bring them all together. You bring them all together. You bring them all together. Why do you bring them all together? Because when you bring like people in a space to where they can now have conversation and dialogue, you're now opening up the floodgates. For instance, I was listening to a podcast the other day, and they were talking about what's the best platform to host your community on. And then they began to talk about what platforms they used. And then after that, then some people began to say, well, do you think you need a platform for people to connect? All of the respondents on the panel, they're like, yes, yes, you need somebody. Yes, you need a place to where the people can be together and connect. Because if you bring them together and they connect with one another, they're less likely to leave because of the relationships they've made in your presence due to you putting together and cultivating the community. So you might say, well, what are places that they can connect? Well, you can create a Telegram for your podcast. You can create a Discord group. You can create a Facebook group. Or they may even connect together in a Patreon group, right? Because some of these are free, some of these are paid, and we'll talk about that on another day, just the difference between free and paid communities. But when you provide that place for them to connect, now you can speak to the group as opposed to speaking to one person one by one. You can give a poll to the group versus giving interviews one by one by one. So now you're able to duplicate your marketing efforts and able to say one thing one time, and then it can spread through the masses faster and easier. And then the last thing that I want to just bring to the forefront is creating community takes place when you create content that people want to share. Let's say you give somebody a podcast how-to, which we love to do on this channel, as you all can see, and as you all may or may not know, we've covered a lot of how-tos on this channel, from how to start your Good Pods podcaster profile, how to create your Good Pods listener profile, and even how to start your own t-shirt printing company. But when you create content like that, you make it to where people want to share it with other individuals because they know somebody else can benefit from it. Why is that so useful? It's useful because now people are sharing your content. People are getting value. And if they get value, then they're going to bring more people into the community. So today I wanted to share with you how to create a podcast community because I feel that it's necessary. And then, like I said, this will be the first of a few episodes that I'm going to do on this topic because I know that this is necessary. But just a quick recap for the Cliff Notes version. First, we said you have to get niched down within your niche. Then you have to encourage your listeners to engage. That's number two, encourage them to engage. Because if you engage, you want to hang out a little bit longer. Then when they're engaging, you ask them, well, what do you want? What do you want to hear? What's beneficial for you? What can we cover? What can we address? Then you provide a place to where they can all commune with one another. Telegram, Discord, Facebook, different things like that. And then the last place is you have to do your job and you have to create content that people want to and they're willing to share. But family, thanks so much for hanging out on the Your Podcast Mentor Show with me, Jonathan Jones. And I want to let you know that if you have not submitted your question, feel free to go to yourpodcastmentorshow.com. And then you can click that microphone at the bottom right-hand corner and you can submit your question and get a chance for me to answer it live on a podcast episode. And then make sure if you haven't registered for the free training, if you're a speaker, coach, or consultant on your podcast show, on yourpodcastmentorshow.com, at the top, it just says free webinar. Click that tab and then you can get registered right then and there. Until next time, family, remember, this is the Your Podcast Mentor Show where we cover the latest in podcast news as well as podcast how-tos to help you build your platform so that you can profit on purpose from your podcast. This is Jonathan Jones. Peace and God bless.